Hi, this is Sharon Glover with the Business Practitioner. It's Strategy Saturday, and this is another episode of Being Strategic. Today, I'm talking about how and why strategies fail. How and why strategies fail. So if you're a small business owner, you're an entrepreneur, of course, you're looking at strategies for your business, and you want them to be effective. But sometimes, it just seems like the strategies are not working. Why? We have to ask that question. So today what I did is I have a few reasons why strategies can fail and how they fail. And so the first reason I want to share with you is execution. One of my favorite mantras is your strategy is only as good as your ability to implement. And of course that makes sense. I mean, what good is strategy if you're not able to execute on that strategy? There are a few things that can challenge you when it comes to execution, but two things I want to speak to today is alignment and process. When I talk about alignment, what I mean is across your business, you really want to make sure that your department and that your teams are aligned, and so everyone is moving together in an individual way across divisions, right? But towards that same vision. So you really do have to have alignment. Otherwise, you have a lot of different things going on and you may not really be headed in the same direction. So alignment is really critical. But the second thing is having a process. And so you really want to make sure that you set up some structure around how do we execute on this strategy and that is communicated across the board in your business. The second thing I want to talk about is buy-in. So you're a CEO and you have vision. That's great. But in order for you to really move that vision forward in an effective way, you have to have buy-in from your staff. You have to have buy-in from your employees. You have to have buy-in for your team. I think too many times CEOs can take the approach of, look, this is the vision, go make it happen. Right? But instead of doing that, if you along the way invite others to get really engaged with that vision, to help you move that vision forward, you will see a lot of, I think you're going to see better results. If you don't do that, you're going to find that things will be slow, they're going to be tedious, and you will be frustrated. When you think about, how many people really want to eat alone, right? So go ahead and invite some people to the table. Get that feedback, get some buy-in, and allow your employees and your teams to really help you move that vision forward. The third thing is prioritizing. Because goals. We have tons of goals, right? But you have to make sure that you get really clear, right? And that you fully understand your capacity as it relates to the goals you're trying to achieve. So what I recommend is, ask yourself, what are our top priorities over the next 12 months? Over the next year, what are those top priorities? Then you can take those and you can break those down into critical milestones that you want to see happen, and then build that out into quarterly 90-day action plans. And I guarantee you're going to see some results. And then the fourth thing I want to say to you is it's important that you assess and you do some analysis. The question is, how do you get where you are right now? What's the current situation and how did you get there? You have to evaluate. Many times CEOs, a company's business put strategies in place, but they really don't go back and look at what's really working and maybe what's not working. Maybe something didn't work and they just, that just failed. We didn't get that right. And then they go on to create something new, as opposed to taking that opportunity to really look at, okay, what types of things have we put in place? How did we go about getting ourselves to where we are right now? And so strategy in and of itself takes, there are several different approaches you can take to strategy. One, of course, is you want to go in, you do that research, you want to be forward thinking, you want to be strategic, you want to look at the trends and look at the market and look at the things that happen and take and gather data to inform decisions. But you also want to make sure that you're looking at those current and emerging trends and that you are nimble enough, flexible enough to shift gears a little bit, to modify and to tweak your strategy a little bit. So those are the things I want to offer to you today as it relates to how and why strategies fail. Make sure that you are taking analysis that, or that you're doing analysis and you're taking an assessment. Make sure that you are prioritizing. You're prioritizing. You have to get that buy-in from all involved because it takes everybody in the business, everybody on the team to really move a business and company forward. And then you always want to make sure that you have a good process and that your company, your business, your team is aligned across the board when it comes to execution. So again, this is Sharon Glover. It's Strategy Saturday, and this is another episode of Being Strategic. I want to thank you so much for watching and for joining me. And you can always find me at thebusinesspractitioner.com. Thanks so much.